Hello, hello. Hello, everyone. We're having a conversation today about the frost in Brazil with Jonas. Let's wait for Jonas to join us. Let's give him a couple of seconds. Okay, let's see if we can get Jonas in. Okay. Hello. Hey.
Hi. How are you?
I'm great. How are you, Jonas?
Fine, fine.
So, welcome everybody to this special Instagram Live. So, my name is Yannis Apostolopoulos and I'm the CEO for Specialty Coffee Association. Today, I will be talking with Jonas Ferraresso about the impacts of the frost in Brazilian coffee production. Jonas is an agronomist and a specialty coffee professional working across coffee's full value chain in the Região do Cerco dos Águas Paulista. So, welcome.
Thank you so much. It's great to be here today and talk a little bit all this climate events that we are facing here in Brazil.
Where are you today?
I'm today in a farm, one of the farms that I work as an advisor, and the farmer it's a organic farm, by the way, and it's a very mountainous area. Usually, some people outside of Brazil think Brazil it's all about flat land, but here is a very mountainous area with coffee arabica.
I see. So let's get on our topics, because you wrote an article for Daily Coffee News last month about the history and the impacts of the frost on Brazil's coffee production. And you include some photos from farms. And I definitely want to talk to you today about what you have witnessed, what the farmers are telling you. But first, I want to give our audience some background, especially for those who may not be familiar with the topic. So just give me 1 second to just put a definition about what is a frost. A ground frost, it's mostly referring to a formation of ice on the ground, objects like trees whose surface has a temperature below the freezing point of water. So, beginning of July, of early July, farms in southern part of Brazil were hit by 3 consecutive days of frost, affecting a range of cash and fruit crops. So, Bloomberg, let me read that, reported at the end of July that Brazil can expect crop losses ranging, and they revised that this week, anywhere between 5 to 10 million bags, which means like 600,000 tons or 1.3 billion pounds. For next year because of this frost, which are expected to continue through the end of August. And the highest estimate at the moment that was brought up is about 8.8 million bags. So the frost comes also after a year that we had like significant droughts that impacted Brazilian farmers. So just to set the context. So Jonas, can first of all, tell us a bit about yourself and your work in Brazil.
Yeah, I work as a coffee agronomist in the whole chain, since farm until cup. I help farmers to put a step up on the coffee chain, so they start to understand how to cup, how to roast, how to brand the coffee. And I work with small and medium farmers in Brazil in no mechanized areas. So they could not use machines here because all the relief is very steep. So they guys trying to give a step on the specialty coffee market, sometimes with high quality beans, sometimes with some kind of certification like organics or Rainforest Alliance or Fair Trade to give more value for their green beans. The idea is grow coffee quality, but starting with the ground, with the agronomics, like good quality soil, good balance with the nature. So all the farmers, I take this approach, bringing more sustainability and to bring quality the coffee for the coffee is a consequence of this good work that we're trying to do on the fields.
Perfect. So can I ask you a question? Like, you're all the time, like, in farms, you're now with farmers and the work with you have been doing. So what are the farmers are telling you about the impacts of the current frost?
Yeah, the impacts in some areas in Brazil were very severe. Places like Cerrado, south of Minas Gerais, northeast of São Paulo state, a region known as Alta Mogiana, and some places in the southeast of São Paulo state is where I'm being, and in Paraná state. It's like a line where the frost from the south went through during the days a few days ago. So the farmers saw some farmers lost all the entire year of crop because of the leaf burning, and some farmers have mild impacts, but they do not understand at all if these mild impacts will bring more some problems for the next season, because first, when we saw the pictures, we just saw places that we have the leaves totally burn, because when the frost come, all the water is like put a bottle of water inside a freeze, so the water inside the plant expand and the cell break it. So when the heat comes in the next day, this water starts to kind of evaporate. They start to get out of the leaves. That's why we saw the drought in the leaves. So because all the water is gone. But sometimes the farmers face other problems, which like this. This is a leaf that was affected by frost. So the leaf is alive, but some parts are dead because of the low temperature. So this is physiological problems that we do not understand yet if the plant nodes, so the plant have the nodes that we see here, and the nodes will grow flowers and fruits along the year. Below a certain level of temperatures, these buds are affected too. They have problems to grow flowers when the rains starts in September. So maybe beyond the burnings that we saw, we will face problems with the sprouting of the flowers in the future. Because many studies of frosts, we don't know exactly, because it's really hard to do scientific research in this climate events. It's not easy to simulate something. So a lot of things you just learn when we have the event. So even all the frosts that are the numbers we are have, there's numbers that we need to stay until September to see if the blossom will occur. So the farmers are worried if the blossom will occur well, not just because this frost damage that I told you in the branch, but because we are facing a long drought in Brazil too. In the last 3 months, many regions are facing no water or just small inches of rain. So the plant is starting to feel the lack of water too, beyond the frost. So nobody's, even mostly the farmers are not sure about if they, even with good plants, they will have a good crop into 2022.
So I was talking with Banuzia yesterday from BSCA, and they said that researchers are trying to do research to understand, like, what is the impact and that will finish somewhere, I think, and they said until end of September.
Yeah.
And Vanusia was telling me that in order to respond to this, the Brazilian government is putting like relief packages for farmers that will reach up to $250 million, if I'm not mistaken. And I wanted to ask, like, considering that we're talking about a loss anywhere between 5 to 10 million bags, is this significant to support the farmers? I know also Vanusia was telling me that the government has committed to that, like, for small, medium farm holders, there will be extra relief packages. Like, but what is your forecast? Because if we actually see the number of bags, it's like almost one third of the bags that they are consumed here in the US, where I am today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's interesting because the government, in association with some institutes and a private company, they're starting to study what is the real impact using satellite images to understand. Because one thing is what we saw is the pictures, but we have to understand for sure what areas were more affected and which farmers will really need this aid to recover the farm. But it's a kind of complicated, even with the satellite studies, because other crops were burned too. So the technicians are trying to separate what is coffee, what's not coffee. So this aid could help these farmers. I think that the money at the first moment will give some relief to them. But we know that the problem with the to like plant the coffee again is a long-term strategy. So it's not just about give some new seedlings or prepare the soil. They will need support along until the third year when the coffee will start to have berries and green beans. So if they lost all the production, they do not have the ways to put money, even if they have a first start. The distribution of the money is very important to be mostly with the small and mediums, because sometimes they do not have an easy way to get some loans for banks because of their size. But it's important to have some strategy for the big farmers too, because they play an important role to the coffee world. So they need some kind of strategy, maybe not a money or but some kind of loans that it's more affordable for them to pay it along the years, because the chain is composed for everyone. So, but everyone needs a different kind of aid. So first, small and medium, which are the in the more I forgot the word. They're more exposed to this problem. And then we have to think to the biggest farmers too, because many of them, they are located in Cerrado of Brazil, are hit severely. So they will need to invest in their lands again to recover again. And the coffee that they produce, they grow, is very important to the coffee chain too.
Yeah. So exactly on this, we put a statement as SCA like a couple of weeks ago on social media, and we called coffee buyers in the special coffee community to reach out to their suppliers, because that's important. Like, communications now is important. So the frost has hit the commodity future market, and buyers will be trying to make sure from one side that the needs are covered. But on the other side also, it may seem counterintuitive. High markets are challenging for some producers, including cooperatives, that they have like contracts in place and they have to fulfill on this one. So green coffee buyers should include communications with both affected and unaffected suppliers as part of their risk mitigating strategy. Mm-hmm. And we think this is critical now. From mm-hmm. your side, what would you add to that? What message do you have for the people that are tuning now in this conversation?
It's, for me, One thing that's really important today that we have and is easy, it's how we the customers could approach more from the farmers or from the roasters that have good relationship with the farmers that they buy green beans, in to find ways that they could give more support. Sometimes farmers not they have another way to help the farmers. Sometimes is they have some kind of stocks with green beans or roasted bean that you could buy directly for the farmer or directly from a roaster that have good direct trade relations. And the farmers really need more, sometimes need more support than the really money. They like to work in the farm. They're not looking for just money. I saw that because I'm being in the fields for 9 years as an agronomist, but a whole life as a person, because I'm son of a farmer and my family is the fourth generation in coffee fields. So farmers love what they do. And they just need ways to continue to work. So it's important to you always buy your coffee for a good for companies or traders that do a fair trade with your or with the farmer and are very sustainable and have good responsibility with their sources. I think this is the best way that people. The customers, the drinker could help the farmers.
So what you're saying is important. And then I've been seeing questions here about the prices. We know the prices are already like 56% up in New York versus last year for the futures mm-hmm. market. But okay, this is the commodity stock exchange. But on the other hand, we have like the internal consumption in Brazil. And we have small, medium roasters in Brazil that they are impacted not only due to high prices, but also with the currency exchange rates today versus dollars. How will this impact them and how will this impact the local consumption in Brazil?
Yeah, it's a problem that many roasters, small and medium roasters mostly, are feeling now, are getting to them, is the price of the internal market of the coffee. Because we have because of the pandemic, we have a raising in the currency of the dollar in Brazil. The dollar are expensive now than 1 year ago. And the bag of coffee, it's expensive too. So small roasters, usually in Brazil, do not have a lot of spare bags to roast. They usually buy the coffee as long as they are needing to roast it. And they play a very important role here in Brazil too. Brazil drinks about 21 million bags of coffee a year. So a very big domestic market. And these small and medium roasters are responsible for many parts of this share of the in some areas, because we have like local brands in some states or even in some cities that they have local brands that support the farmers from this specific area in Brazil. So they are very worried how they could buy a so high price green bean and sell the roasted coffee for affordable prices for the Brazilian customer, because you still have Brazilians, you know, coffee, it's kind of part of our life. It's very common to have coffee everywhere, but we are not sure about how much the customers are willing to pay for a bag of roasted coffee, because we never face something like that. Usually coffee is not so expensive in Brazil to be affordable for everyone. But now we don't know if the prices go so high, people are start to changing the coffee or drink less coffee. It's something that we don't have the numbers yet. And the roasters, these small roasters are worried if they could put this percentage of prices in the roasted beans, and they will continue continuing to sell the coffee as the roasted coffee as expected. There are even people trying to talk with the government in Brazil, some representatives of the coffee industry, to find some way that these small and medium roasters have some kind of support or some kind of way to mitigate this big step on prices for green beans.
I see. So, Jonas, I think that it's really important to say, like, you have been working like for 9 years now as an agronomist. And even though some people like refuse to acknowledge climate change, I think it will be one of the major issues that we're going to face and we're already facing. So from your experience on the farm, how severe have been like those extreme weather phenomena that impact farmers over the last years?
Since 2014, when we have a big drought in Brazil, and Brazil never, the areas never recovered well. We have areas with coffea canephora in a state called Espírito Santo in Brazil. There are many producers could not yet recover from 2014 drought that we have. In areas of Arabicas, this drought was the difference, because since then, many of the sources that farmers have, like springs that they have inside the farms, never recover again. And every year we have is some months that usually are not very dry, but starting to be very dry, like we have last year. The season we are harvesting these years were affected by the drought that we have last year. That take about 3 to 4 months without any considerable rain. And in January and in February, we have about 1 month and a half or 2 months without the volume of rain that we are expecting to. And now during the harvest season, we usually experience some rain during, not much, but we usually have some rains. And we are facing, again, a lack of water in many coffee areas. So the changing, if we talk with a farmer, I said a real farmer, he knows that something happens, because every year he struggles more to grow coffee or even to start new areas, because to have new plants on the fields, rain is very important. I know we have some many technologies related to irrigation, but for irrigation, we need water. No matter if I have the irrigation system, like many places in Brazil now have good irrigation systems that they cannot put to work because they do not have water to take it to put in the irrigation system. So and now we are facing another problem with was the frost. And I have something to add to many areas in Brazil that I have reports in the last week are having problems with fires. And it's very dangerous now, because many of the viewers already saw the pictures of a dried coffee area which was hit by the frost. It's terrible. If just a match go there and everything's burned, because we have all dried leaves on the ground. And I saw some friends, agronomists, sent to me places that already some farms which was hit by frost now are facing the fires inside the coffee land. So it's been a point, in my opinion, that it's kind of, we are in the fringe of a high risk problem, and we have to think very serious about not just directed for the climate change, but the people that are being affected by that, that need the farm to bring food or money and to their families. It's something that, in my opinion, it's impossible to ignore.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. And climate change is here, and it's something that we all need to act upon, especially with the help from governments, and everybody needs to put an effort there. So thank you very much for joining us and sharing your perspective, Jonas. Like, and for helping, first of all, elevating the voices of the farmers who have been affected by this. I would like, first of all, to remind to our community again to please reach out to your suppliers, keep the communication strong, and continue to support the community in Brazil. I want to thank everybody who was here and who attended that Instagram Live. And thank you again so much.
Thank you. Thank you. It's very great to be here today to talk with you.
Thank you all. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.